Let's see here. What am I supposed to do? Talk about what I'm doing? It's kind of boring. I mean, there's not anything else. Oh! Can I get a hand, Sophia? Yeah, go for it. Am I missing a slide? Back. That's weird. Okay. For Rich and the rest of the class.
Minutes is not so long, so here's a quick one about the work I've done. First things first is the place and time, late September on Chimney Mine. There inside of the fraud and out county lies a sulfurous mineral bounty in 1909. So the story goes, people went digging in looking for gold, but the mine got flooded in 32. Just sat around for a decade or two, but the people came back to that mine so old, so they saw it didn't profit to mine their gold. But scientists still like to take a stroll, and with that I'll tell you my research goals. The first off goal was to map the land and see what the rocks could help us understand. The other one was to test the groundwater and see what the waste piles had to offer. With the compass and eye, we paced profoundly and marked on the lines of the rock type boundaries. Over the hills like mountain creatures, we slowly worked out all the folded features, and we drew them on skin map bit by bit. Parts that kind of looks like, and we drew groundwater from many a place, some of which were below the mine waste, but others were in sights much further away. Install a piezometer, hope and pray. We thought drawing water would be a cinch, but the memory of it still makes me wince. And the cost of learning is inexpensive, but a room full of monkey makes some defensive. But we got our samples in record time, and then it was time to analyze. The spectrophotometer measured iron, the pH levels that lower and higher, without the lead in the O2, and sulfate levels all through and through. And whether or not that data was skewed, it sure dictated the conclusions I drew. It seemed like the land had folded a lot, back when the rock was deep and hot, as the bedding had shifted and formed a U. Its inclined fold that carried through the amphibolite in the outer bed, followed by the quartzite overhead. Schist came next in high abundance, then metaconglomerate, which is the youngest minor folding occurred right here, which caused the layers to break and veer. The oasis site sediments were fairly clean, high amounts of sulfates were rarely seen, but the waste rock ones were a different case, because they uptake sulfur at a different pace. Sulfide rocks are at high concentrations and can't escape uranium's penetration, so the sulfides leach and occupy the waste rock piled around water supply.
So what did I learn?
With contaminated water, as a matter of course, waste rock's likely a significant source. And I surely learned that you should never dine on water that drained from its chimney mine. And the rocks beneath us are more than we make of it. Take a little time, and you can learn the shape of it. And that's the end of the song I wrote. I hope you enjoyed the anecdote. There's not much time for any afterthought, so I gotta thank Rich for a science course well taught.